that these two functions are bounded or unbounded. Okay, let's see. So in this case, what? In this case, f of x is equal to 1 upon 2 to the power of x belongs to 1 comma 2 minus 1, correct? 1 upon 2 to the power of 1 minus 1 is 0, 2 minus 1 is 1. So here we can write as 1 upon 2 power 0 is 1, okay, and 2 power 1 is 2. So then we can write as 1 upon 1 is 1, 1 upon 2 is 2, 1 by 2 comma 1. So it is bounded function, right? Now in this case, now if you see this case, f of x is equal to, we can write 2 to the power of 1 upon 1 by 2 minus 1, right? Then you get as 2 to the power of 1 upon 1 minus 1 is how much? 0. 2 minus 1 is how much? 1. Now you get as 2 to the power of 1 by 0 is infinity, 1 by 1 is 1, 1 comma infinity. So this I can write as 2 to the power of 1 comma 2 to the power of infinity. That is, I get as 2 comma infinity. 2 comma infinity is which function? Unbounded. This is unbounded, that is bounded. So you know that if I send this side, sin c minus sin d formula, 2 cos c plus d by 2, c plus d by 2 into sin c minus d by 2, okay, is equals to 0. This plus x minus x cancel out. You get here 2 cos 2x plus t divided by 2 into sin t by 2 is equal to 0. So product of the things is 0, any one of them 0. Sin t by 2 is equal to 0. If sine argument is 0, it will be true for that argument is equal to sine theta is 0, then theta is equal to n pi, where n belongs to I. So t value you get as t is equal to 2 n pi, where n belongs to I. If I keep 0, 0 is not allowed, t is greater than 0, so we have to allow from 1. So if I keep n is equal to 1, then t is equal to 2 pi. So this is the period of the function. Right? If you see the graph of the function, trigonometry, other you can use the condition that f of x plus t is equal to f of x for all x belongs to domain of the function f. So such function is called a periodic function. Correct? So here I already informed you sin x period is 2 pi. And its reciprocal cosec x also will be 2 pi, because you know the graph will repeat, na graph. So cosec x also 2 pi. Sec x cos x also 2 pi. You know the graph, no need to explain, na graph. Right. Then tan and cot. You can see tan cot graph, how it will be there. Here pi by 2 will be there. Right. Pi by 2. So here it will start from like this, na here. How tan 0 is 0. Right. Tan 45 is 1, na? Tan 45 is 1. Next tan infinity, it goes like this, na? Pi by 2, it goes like this, right? It goes like this. And then here it goes down this side. It goes like this, like this. This is tan. Right? So here positive side. This is the length is pi by 2. And this is minus pi by 2. So minus pi by 2 plus. So here to here graph will be repeats every place. So this pi by 2 and this is minus pi by 2. The period will be how much? Pi. Pi will be the period. Understood, na? This box will repeat everywhere. So period is how much? Pi. Pi is the period. So like here tan and cot also period is how much? Pi. What is the fractional part function? Period of partial fractional part function. See, graph of partial fractional part function is, this is 0, here 1, and then you get here 2. Likewise it is goes on, like this is goes on. And here the period is how much? You can see that this is repeating after 1. This is repeating after 1. This is repeating. This graph is repeating after one. So period is how much? One. Okay. So fractional part function period is one. Sine and cosec is 2π. Cos and sec is 2π. Cot and tan is 2π. Okay. Graph you know na? You just if you remember the graph, you will get everything. Right?